tradition says that death has been conquered by Savitri. If that is the case, then why do we see death on earth? Here is an explanation from Sri Aurobindo's Savitri. To understand this, let us go back to the characters of the story. All characters are incarnations or emanations of living and conscious forces with whom we can enter into concrete touch. Satyavan is the soul carrying the divine truth of being within itself, but descended into the grip of death and ignorance. Savitri is the divine word, goddess of the supreme truth, who comes down and is born to save the human race. Ashwapati, the lord of the horse, is her human father. Also, the lord of tapasya, who does his severe tapasya for 18 years to liberate humanity and for that to get Savitri as his daughter. Yumatsena, the lord of shining hosts, father of Satyavan, is the divine mind, here fallen blind, losing its celestial kingdom of vision and glory. The story: Ashwapati does his intense tapasya for 18 years to liberate humanity. The divine mother Aditi, hearing his call, decides to be born his daughter Savitri. Savitri is in search of her counterpart, who is constantly aspiring to be released from the yoke of earthly slavery. When she meets Satyavan, she realizes at once the task she has to discharge on earth, and hence decides to marry him instantly. Sage Narada warns Ashwapati about Satyavan's impending ill fate, that he would die in a year's time. But Savitri is adamant, and Ashwapati, knowing his daughter's divine nature, lets his daughter's wish to materialize. Soon after their marriage, Savitri faces reality and she does her intense tapasya and prepares herself for the big day. She liberates her inner self and awaits the doomed day. On the day when Satyavan has to die, she accompanies him to the forest, and when Lord Yama comes for Satyavan's life, she quietly follows him. Yama lures her with all possible riches, but she remains stubborn and fixed on Satyavan's life. Gradually, Yama understands who Savitri truly is, the Divine Mother, and lets her light conquer the falsehood and darkness that he is an embodiment of. Savitri conquers death on earth and opens possibility of a new creation in the subtle physical world. She opens the gate for men's evolution, the truth that is destined to humanity, which he will manifest. Satyavan gets his life, but not on the mortal physical body, but on the immortal subtle physical body, which is existing on the very earth. Just like apes became humans, so has now the frontiers opened to us by Savitri and Satyavan to step into the subtle physical world for our evolution, where the limitations of human mind, human power, and the physical material body shall be crossed and immortality achieved. The integral yoga of Sri Aurobindo and the mother have opened the supramental floods to reach Earth. Earth is now ready to step into its destined future. Let us aspire and accelerate our evolution, where our birthright of immortality, freedom, love, and light are awaiting us. Thank you.